Today in the shop, we are looking at a 2015 6.7 liter diesel with a check engine light on. The customer complaint on this truck is the check engine light is on, and I'm going to be using 4-scan light along with an iPhone and an OBD Link MX Plus Bluetooth adapter today for diagnosis. In the powertrain control module, we have a P202D reductant leakage code and a P20E8 reductant pressure too low code. Now this truck had the reductant pump replaced about 6 weeks ago for a similar issue. P202D reductant leakage is kind of a misleading code. It doesn't necessarily mean there's leakage in the system. It sets if the reductant pump has to maintain a duty cycle higher than 50% to maintain system pressure, and system pressure is usually around 72 psi. But if it has to run a higher than 50% duty cycle to maintain that pressure when the injector is closed or there's no flow in the system, then it flags a P202D. P20E8 sets if the reductant system pressure is lower than 51 psi 45 seconds after the pump is commanded on. So it's definitely looking like we have some issues with our reductant system, and specifically with the pressures in our reductant system. On a quick visual inspection, I'm not seeing any external leaks on this system, so I think we're going to monitor some PIDs and take it for a test drive. The PCM is turned on the reductant pump and it's at a 40% duty cycle, and we're having some trouble building pressure. So it's turned the duty cycle up to 80% and we're still having some trouble building pressure. And I think 80% is the maximum duty cycle the PCM will ever put on the reductant pump. But if you watch, the reductant pressure just slowly keeps creeping up. I'm going to go ahead and jump ahead a few minutes in this recording. You can see here that the system does eventually build 72 PSI, and when it does, the duty cycle in the pump drops down to 22 or 23%, which is normal. And then the duty cycle starts coming up on the pump to hold that pressure. So we're still around a 40% duty cycle, a little higher than we should be, but the pressure looks good, our injector's still cycling, the duty cycle on our pump's actually starting to come back down a little, and then it goes up a bunch more. It comes back down a little, goes up some more, goes up a bunch more. And if you look at the pressure, we're not even holding 70 PSI anymore, and we're working this hard, and now we're at 80% duty cycle. So now the pump's maxed out on its duty cycle, and we're only running low 60s or high 50s for pressure. So now that we've got an idea what the PCM is seeing that's making it flag these codes, it's probably time we start looking around on the vehicle and trying to figure out what's going on. The reductant pump is located on top of the reductant tank, and I'm going to start by pulling all the electrical connectors apart on the harness of the reductant tank and inspecting them for moisture or corrosion. We've got some dirt in the electrical connector at the pump from when we disconnected it, but I don't see any corrosion on the pins. And that's dielectric grease, not water, on the pump connector. So I'm not really finding any corrosion or issues on any of the connectors. And I think next we're going to start checking out some of the wiring and electrical system. I've got battery voltage on pin 3 and the circuit load tests okay. Pin 1 and pin 4 are both less than 1 ohm back to ground. And pin 5 at the reductant pump is showing less than an ohm of resistance to pin 23 at the PCM. And I'm not measuring any cross short to voltage or to ground. A reductant leakage test with an IDS shows similar results where it struggles to build even 60 PSI. I went ahead and pulled the reductant injector off the exhaust and ran a flow test just to make sure the injector wasn't stuck open and dumping the pressure off. But I think if that was the case, we'd have other issues. At this point, I went ahead and pulled the reductant tank out, and I think we're going to try replacing the pump. And you don't have to pull the heater or sender assembly to replace the pump. I just wanted to check the tank for contamination. I just want to verify that there's nothing that could have caused this pump to fail in 6 weeks or that's going to cause another new pump to fail immediately. And I'm not seeing any signs of contaminants in the tank, so I think we're going to go ahead and try a reductant pump on this. New reductant pump's installed. Let's see what our pressures look like. So here it's holding the injector wide open and running the pump to purge the air from the reductant line. And our injector is closed, the pump's at 80% duty cycle, we should start seeing some pressure. And there we go, we got 77 PSI. And you'll notice how much faster the pressure came up than it did last time, and now our duty cycle on the pump I think is 16% to hold that pressure. And I took this vehicle on a 15 or 20 minute test drive out on the highway, and it held good pressure the entire time. I think the highest duty cycle I saw on the pump was 25% or so. The codes all cleared and they didn't come back, and before I could get the codes back on every test drive, so I think we're going to call this fixed. If you found this helpful or interesting, please click the like button down below. I got a lot more great stuff coming up, so please subscribe, and as always, have a great week.